Oh, hey, Gian. You're back. How's your vacation? Well, I've been thinking.
You've been thinking?
Yes.
Thinking.
Well, what are you thinking?
Gigabase!
Wait. You said early on this season, you're not making a megabase.
Yup.
And you also said you're keeping things small this season.
Yup.
And now, you're thinking about making a gigabase?
Yes!
And inviting all the Botem to band together in a single corporation. To form the Botem Incorporated. So, is everyone in?
Sure.
Yup. Yes? Pearl, are you in? Pearl?
Mountain!
I'm proud. So yeah, business. When we think about business, we always think of large corporations, capitalism, and money. But businesses in Hermitcraft are really just shops. I mean, shops that turn into little large corporations competing with one another. Hermitcraft every season usually have shops in a single area, forming a central commercial hub called the Shopping District. And in this central hub, we witness a lot of groups and events formed, like the Logfellas and Log Wars from Season 4, Concorp and Sahara from Season 6, and the gigantic Barge Empire and the totally highly successful Shop of Pacific from Season 7. But this season, the Hermits collectively decided to live in a single continent, living in various regions, making shops becoming decentralized and separated across the continent. But these guys out here, namely B-Dubs and Grian, decided that, you know what? I miss a shopping district. So why not we make our own shopping district?
Amazing!
And so they did. B-Dubs and Grian, together with their own groups, formed their own commercial hubs and united their mega bases to form gigabases. But these separate commercial hubs will instigate competition among the corporations and business groups in the server. And possibly, it could escalate into a full-blown war. Or specifically, a tycoon war. And we all know that wars in Hermitcraft mean one thing. Beautiful content. Anyway, recently, there are a lot of shops popping out left and right. The introduction of derp coins, people access a currency, and big corporations on the rise to compete in this new tycoon market. And so, there are four rising business groups that could potentially compete with one another in this new era of shopping in Hermitcraft. Starting with their first group, the Botem Inc. So, Botem. Pretty much everyone knows this area very well. I mean, there's a bowl, a hole, and now, a goal. The Botem crew recently had a cult, a business meeting, below the Botem pole with their very interesting seats. And in this meeting, they settled upon a unification of the Botem community under a single corporate entity called the Botem Inc. Oh, and also, they're making a gigabase, which is basically a collection of bases and mega bases to form one big giant gigabase. Gigabases aside, the Botem collectively decided to form a shopping district in the server that could benefit a lot of the hermits in the region. This move with the Botem could attract a lot of the hermits to shop and do business in the Botem shopping district. The region already has a lot of shops like the G-Train, Padlamako, the totally eco-friendly Harmus Harvest, Scar's Wagon, and Impulse's eye-branded shops. This solidifies the northern region as the main area for shopping in the continent and could generate a lot of diamonds. But their neighbors from the east and west are also vying in this potential market. Next up, we have the Hermits, who hates Birch and have the biggest eyes in the server, namely the Big Eyes group. This group, formed by B-Dubs, Kralis, and Tango, settled in the eastern region. At the beginning of the season, they began building their starter bases very close by, and they could also have a potential gigabase situation, similar with the Botem crew. This group also have a joint business venture with their pass and gas shops, strategically placed in the various road networks also built by the Big Eyes across the continent. The original business venture benefited the Hermits in having a pass and gas shop close by, but this crazy guy named B-Dubs, who builds literal roads and mountains for the sake of having a nice background, decided to found a new shopping district for the Big Eyes. At the Big Eyes Cove, they plan to construct various shops for specific items to sell from. This move will bring competition to the Bodom crew up north, and will become a major player in the upcoming Tycoon Wars. Next up, we have the Octagon Inc. So, you probably noticed all the crap, spider, walker, Star Wars, like structures popping out in the vicinity of the Bodom and the other areas in the continent. These structures were built by the Octagon Inc., formerly the Gotham Empire and the Randok Business Empire venture. Randok and Doc with their advanced farms, like the farms in the Curse Trunk and the Shocker Farm, sponsored by Psycraft, have the potential to bring in their superior farms into the Hermitcraft community. Similar to the Bodom and the Big Eyes, they will also be constructing a shopping district that will be called as the Octagon. It will be located in this island, just near the vicinity of the Bodom shopping district. With the Octagon being close to the Bodom, this could escalate tensions between the two groups, and their relations with one another are not necessarily in good terms. This could potentially ignite the flame that could start the Tycoon Wars. These three groups are building shopping districts to compete with one another for dominance and the potential market. But hidden in the shadows, there's a particular group that controls almost half of the server with their soul gathering. And that is the Horsehead Farms. Deep in the southern region, you probably don't know what's happening from down here, since not a lot of hermits visit this region very often. But there's one particular shop that attracted a lot of the hermits, and it is the Horsehead Farms. So, it is a business scheme formed by XV and Hypno that is located at the southernmost part of the server. This business is very different out of all the major businesses mentioned, unlike the other shops in the server where hermits just set up a shop, place products, and stonks. XV and Hypno has a different plan in mind. Instead of using diamonds, they trade in huge stockpile of resources in exchange for your soul. Not the spiritual soul part, but more of committing yourself to sign a contract, or we may call in the Hermitcraft server as an IOU. These three letters written in a piece of paper may seem like just an ordinary piece of paper, but it holds way more than that, since IOUs basically means literally selling your soul to someone and following whatever order they want if someone turned a piece of paper in. IOUs in Hermitcraft instigated a lot of important events, such as Falls turning his green IOU for a prank at the HRN way back in Season 6. IOUs can literally be just asking a hermit to help you out with anything. Or much more interesting, it can also start a war. As of now, XV and Hypno's business scheme controls a lot of IOUs in the server from various hermits across the continent. They currently hold half of the souls of the Hermitcraft server, and this leverage will make them one of the most powerful tycoons in the server. They have the potential to become a key player in the Tycoon Wars that could happen in the server with all the competing businesses, shopping districts, and shops emerging in this new era of shopping in Hermitcraft. Did the tree just move? Nope.